The last thing I need to talk about relating to lipid metabolism is fatty acid synthesis. This process is stimulated by insulin and therefore occurs under high glucose conditions, when the body has a lot of energy. That's a good time for biosynthesis in general and to add to the body's energy reserves. The fatty acids made in this process can be stored as triacylglycerols, or they can become part of a glycerol phospholipid or sphingolipid. Under high glucose conditions, most of the acetyl-CoA in the cell will come from pyruvate, one of the products of glycolysis. Recall that pyruvate decarboxylation to produce acetyl-CoA occurs in the mitochondrial matrix. However, synthesis of fatty acids occurs in the cytosol to separate it from beta oxidation of fatty acids. Therefore, we need a way to move acetyl-CoA from the matrix into the cytosol. This happens by a process called the citrate transport system. The idea here is similar to that of the malate aspartate shuttle, which moves electrons from cytosolic NADH into the matrix. In the citrate transport system, a series of chemical reactions and transport steps occur, the net result of which is hydrolysis of two ATP molecules to ADP to drive movement of acetyl-CoA from the matrix into the cytosol. During these reactions, two electrons are taken from NADH and moved to NAD+ to produce NADPH. Now, you don't need to worry about the details of the reactions in the citrate transport system, but you should remember the things that I've put in these two boxes here. Note that production of NADPH during this process is helpful because NADPH is required for the synthesis of fatty acids. The process by which fatty acids are synthesized is similar to the process of beta oxidation of fatty acids, just in the opposite direction. Two carbon units are added to a growing hydrocarbon chain in a series of four reactions. The process is driven forward by hydrolysis of ATP. Four electrons must be added for every turn of the cycle, and these come from NADPH. The major product of fatty acid synthesis is palmitate, the 16-carbon saturated fatty acid. The net reaction for synthesis of palmitate is shown. It takes seven cycles of the four reactions to produce palmitate. In the first cycle, two acetyl groups are joined to make a four-carbon unit. After the second cycle, we have a six-carbon unit, and so on. In the seven cycles, 14 molecules of NADPH and seven molecules of ATP are consumed. The palmitate that is produced can be stored in triacylglycerols, or it can be used to make membrane lipids. Note that we can make lipids that are shorter or longer than 16 carbons. Our cells also have enzymes to add double bonds, but not in every position that we have to. Therefore, we must obtain certain unsaturated fatty acids in our diet. This concludes our consideration of lipid metabolism. In the next topic, I will try to summarize and integrate the different pathways of energy metabolism that we have looked at.